Welcome to Morning Man with Pastor Steve Myrie.
This morning's topic, check out God's resume.
Then the Lord answered Job from the whirlwind. Who is this that questions my wisdom with such ignorance? Brace yourself like a man, because I have some questions for you, and you must answer them. Where were you when I laid the foundations of the earth? Tell me if you know so much. Job 38, 1 through 4. A resume is defined as a document that lists your work experience, education, skills, and achievements. You need a resume in order to get a job that you apply for. The Lord wants to be our defender. He wants to be our protector. He wants to be the I am that I am to all of us. As with everyone who desires a job, their resume will speak for them. And so to turn over your will, to turn over your entire life to Him, it's only fair that you check out His resume. When we look at God's resume, His address can be found in Ephesians 1 verse 20, which tells us He's at the right hand of God in heaven. His phone number, Romans 10 verse 13, which reminds us that whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. His name is Jesus Christ. His name was carried by angels. His name can be used for baptism, healing, and deliverance. There is power in this name, and joy is also in this name. He goes by the alias Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father. Some call Him the Lily of the Valley, Joy in My Sorrow, Comfort to My Pain. Oh, He's also the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. His qualifications: He made the heavens and the earth. He formed man from the dust of the ground. He also redeemed man from the curse of the law. His occupational background: He only had one employer. His employer has nothing but rave reviews for Him. His employer said, "This is My beloved Son, with whom I'm well pleased." He had never been tardy, absent, disobedient, slothful, or disrespectful. Oh, and that Lazarus thing, that was actually intentional. It was a part of the job. Speaking of Lazarus, his skills and work experience: He raised Lazarus from the dead, turned water into wine. He walked on water. He gave the blind back their sight. His educational background: He encompasses the entire breadth and length of knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. References: Sarah said, "He gave life to my womb." Shunammite woman said, "He gave me back my dead son." Dr. S.M. Lockridge said, "He's available for the tempted and tried. He sympathizes and He saves. He guides and He keeps all His people." God expects us to use yesterday's experience with Him as a reference of what He's able to do today. Job started out well. He trusted God. But then it's not about how we start out. Y'all remember? Yes, when it just started, Job said, "The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh." He said, "Naked came I out of my mother's womb, and naked I shall go." But as things got intensified, as things increased, and when you think it couldn't get any worse, his friends came and said, "Job, what is happening is your fault." Job did not want to curse God as his wife told him to, but his wife planted a seed in Job's head. And so Job said, "Curse the day that I was born." Every time we doubt God, every time we murmur and complain, every time we say we are giving up, we are doing nothing short of disrespecting the creator of this universe. In other words, child of God, God's resume said that He is able to keep you. God's resume said that He is able to provide for you. God's resume said that He is able to love you when you don't even feel lovable. The quote of the day: God expects us to use yesterday's experience as a reference for what He is going to do today. As you go today, go knowing that God has got your back and He's more than able to get the job done. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated. Hey, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.